Several months into the COVID-19 pandemic, definite patterns regarding the spread of the novel coronavirus are emerging, and they show that cities that figure predominantly in the international tourist and passenger map are the worst hit. Therefore, cities like Mumbai, New York City, London, and Singapore happen to be the worst affected, while the pandemic in the countryside has been either subdued or just a mere spillover of these mega cosmopolitan cities. The pandemic has been more or less reduced to mega cities where multiculturalism has deepened its roots. Foreign travelers entering these cities, welcomed by beautiful and grand international airports, have brought along the deadly virus with them. Take, for example, the New York City, which is popular as a global cosmopolitan hub. More than 60 million tourists visit the city every day, and by 2018, it already had more than 3.1 million immigrants, several of them naturalized US citizens, and many of them permanent lawful residents. Then the undocumented population is estimated to be as high as 5,60,000. These are people from different parts of the world residing in New York City, which has emerged as the epitome of global cosmopolitanism. Politically, New York truly believes in the idea of multiculturalism, that is, migration and coexistence of people from different countries at one place. This has been eulogized all this while as New York City became a popular destination for migrant workers and tourists from across the world. But during the coronavirus pandemic, it has actually proved to be the reason behind this devastating death toll of New York City. Multiculturalism brings high air traffic along with it, and when a pandemic strikes the world, the air traffic introduces coronavirus. New York has the busiest international airports in the country, with thousands of international passengers from China, the Middle East, and Europe pouring in every day. Therefore, it doesn't come as a surprise that the first known infection in the New York state was an Iranian health worker who had returned to the US from his native country and tested positive merely 2 days of his arrival. Today, it is recognized that most of the cases in New York City came from Europe, showing how multiculturalism and cosmopolitanism, ideas that have defined the city all this while, have engulfed it in the pandemic. Out of 1.2 million cases in the United States, there are as many as 1,78,000 cases in New York City alone. The number is higher than several European countries from where migrants brought the coronavirus to New York City in the first place. No different is the case in London, where the number of cases has risen sharply to 25,499 out of 2,06,715 confirmed cases in all of the UK. What made London susceptible is again a high concentration of migrant population and a culture of ghettoized foreign populations in the capital. London is defined by multiculturalism and cosmopolitanism, much like the entire New York City. More than 3.2 million foreign-born people live in London, making it the hub of migrant population in the United Kingdom. While 38% of the United Kingdom's migrant population lives in London, only 10% of UK-born people live in the British capital. Many of these migrants, including Chinese migrants, live in overcrowded places that further become the hotbeds for the spread of an outbreak like the coronavirus pandemic. Again, many of the migrants are undocumented, which encourages ghettoization and overcrowded spaces. What multiculturalism does is to create a migrant population that flies in and out of the city frequently. This is why the Heathrow International Airport happens to be one of the busiest in the world, and it doesn't really come as a surprise that the first novel Wuhan virus case in London was that of a Chinese national. The first case was reported in February, and the number of cases has kept on piling ever since. In line with this trend, Mumbai happens to be the worst affected city in India, with 11,394 confirmed cases out of 56,000 cases in the country. Mumbai carries almost 20% of the total cases. Within India, Mumbai happens to be one of the most cosmopolitan cities, being one of the most visited cities in the world in 2019. Mumbai International Airport too happens to be the busiest single runway airport in the world. While it is a poorly enforced lockdown and maladministration on the part of the Mahavikas Aghadi coalition government that has contributed to a surge in the cases in Mumbai, the incoming air traffic into Mumbai from coronavirus-affected parts of the world, such as the Gulf, is what made the Mumbai vulnerable to the pandemic in the first place. Singapore, another multicultural migration hub that has become a coronavirus hotspot, reported as many as 558 coronavirus cases from dormitories used by foreign workers. Singapore has a heavy concentration of migrants from other parts of Asia, such as China, India, and Pakistan, leading to the creation of cramped up dormitories. These overpopulated dormitories have made Singapore a coronavirus hotspot. And last month, 90% of the cases emerging in Singapore were attributed to dormitories inhabited by foreign workers. The city-state of Singapore now has over 21,000 confirmed coronavirus cases. New York, Mumbai, Singapore, and London, some of the worst-hit cities, therefore explain how multiculturalism and cosmopolitanism have facilitated and exacerbated the spread of the coronavirus pandemic. Therefore, it goes without saying that the idea of multiculturalism will take a massive hit post the coronavirus pandemic.